pinagpabalan niya, and I will discuss about why and how management control. The goal of my report is to know why and how managers control. The importance of controlling, the different types of control, internal and external control. First, let's define controlling. According to Harold Knutz, controlling is the measurement and correction of performance in order to make sure that enterprise objectives and the plans devised to attain them are accomplished. While Henry Fayol stated that control of an undertaking consists of seeing that everything is being carried out in accordance with the plan which has been adopted, the orders which have been given, and the principle which have been laid down. Its objective is to point out mistakes in order that they may be rectified and prevented from recurring. Functions of management. The first function of management is planning. It is the determining process of action. Planning means setting an organization's goals and deciding how best to achieve them. The plan helps maintain managerial effectiveness as it works as a guide for future activities. Organizing, coordination of activities and resources. Once the manager sets goals and develop plans, the next managerial function is organizing human resources and other resources identified as necessary by the plan to reach the goal. The third one is leading, managing and motivating people. The third managerial function is leading. It is the skills of influencing people for a particular purpose or reason. Leading is considered to be the most important and challenging of all managerial activities. Leading is influencing or prompting the organization member to work together with the interest of the organization. And the next is controlling, monitoring and evaluating activities. Monitoring the organizational progress toward goal fulfillment is controlling. Controlling is measuring, comparing, finding deviation, and correcting the organizational activities performed to achieve the goal or objectives of the organization. Yan. So, yung sa controlling po, yung result nun, pwede nating magamit para paggagawa tayo ng plano, kunwari next year, ay mas maayos na kasi nakita na natin dun sa controlling process kung ano yung mga dapat nating i-improve. Next po. Why managers control? Control helps manager monitor the effectiveness of their planning, organizing, and leading activities. It determines what is being accomplished, and it also viewed as detecting and correcting significant variation in the result obtained from planned activities. In short, dito sa function na to nasusukat kung napaperform ba ng maayos at according sa standards ang mga organizational activities. Dito din nakikita kung may mga kailangan bang baguhin sa sinet nating plano para sa taong ito at para ma-achieve yung goal ng management or organization. Importance of controlling. It helps in accomplishing organizational goals. A good controlling system comes to the rescue of a manager and helps an organization in different ways through controlling function. A manager can help his team on keep on the right track to achieve organizational goals. Next quote. Enables management judging accuracy of standards. An efficient controlling system helps a manager to verify the accuracy of the standard set. can also review and revise the standards as per changes taking place in and out of the organization through an efficient controlling system. Number three, facilitates efficient use of resources. Through an efficient controlling system, a manager can ensure that that resources are used in the most effective and efficient manner. Bale, for example po yung sa DOH at saka sa PSDBM, dun kinokontrol nila kung tama ba yung pagkakagamit ng pondo o may mga mas dapat pa bang pondohan or tama ba yung pagkaka-procure. Dun po sa controlling ma-determine kung effective ba at efficient yung pagkakagamit nila ng resources or pondo ng gobyerno. As per example po. Helps improving employees' motivation. A good controlling system motivates employees and helps them to perform better. The controlling function tells employees about the work they expect to do, as well as about the standards of performance on the basis of which they will be appraised. Ang example po nito yung sa mostly sa private po ito. Yung, di ba po, sa sales, nagkakaroon ng mga top employees. Ito po yung one way para i-motivate yung mga empleyado na mas mag-perform pa ng mas maganda sa mga susunod pa na mga sales nila. Eight, atmosphere of order and discipline. An efficient controlling system helps to minimize dishonest behavior on part of the employees by keeping a close check on their day-to-day activities. Ang example po nito ay yung manager na nagtatry na ma-reduce yung inefficiency ng empleyado by monitoring internet activity. Kasi po merong mga empleyado na kala mo busy-busy yun pala, nag-Shopee, naglalasada sa opisina, ganun. So, pwede po na mamonitor yon ng manager by assigning the IT staff na malimit po yung mga pwedeng ma-access ng empleyado para yung para mas maging productive siya sa opisina. Tsaka para ma-lessen din po yung pag-conduct ng personal business and dun sa opisina. Facilitates coordination and action. Controlling function facilitates coordination in the organization. It helps maintain equilibrium between means and ends. It makes sure that proper direction is taken and that various factors are maintained properly. Next is types of control. Feed-forward controls. Employed before a work activity begins. It ensures that objectives are clear, proper directions are established, and right resources are available. It focuses on quality of resources. Ito pong feed-forward control is also known as preventive control. Ginagawa ito bago yung work activity. Concurrent controls focus on what happens during work process. It monitors ongoing operation to make sure they are being done according to plan. It can reduce waste in unacceptable finished products or services. Ang example po nito ay yung sa factory. Kapag may trabahador dun sa factory na na-notice niya na maraming mga damage na items na na-produce yung machine, kailangan niya agad itawag yun dun sa manager nila para ma-prevent, para ma-check nila kung bakit ba nangyayari yun. At kasi pag pinagpatuloy nila yung production na hindi chine-check yung mga machines nila, pwede yung mag-result sa madaming damage items at masasayang yung resources na ginagamit nila. Feedback control. Feedback control takes place after work is completed. It focuses on quality of end results and provide useful information for improving future operations. Ang example po nito ay yung kapag may sinet na, kunwari sa sales, kapag may sinet na sales goal yung isang kumpanya na dapat nilang ma-reach sa loob ng 3 buwan, marireview pa yun ng manager or ng management pagkatapos yung 3 buwan. Doon pa lang makikita ng management kung na-achieve ba nung personnel nila yung sinet na sales goal. In case na hindi na-achieve yung goal nung company, doon pa lang pwedeng mag-implement ng pagbabago sa plano yung manager. Tapos after 3 months ulit, doon pa lang ulit marireview kung na-achieve na ba yung goal nila. Ang disadvantage lang sa feedback control, yung modification ay magagawa pa after ng process o after na yung action ay naganap na. So, a situation may have ended before managers are aware of any issues. Therefore, feedback controls is more suited for processes, behaviors, or events that are repeated over time rather than those that are not repeated. So, ang feedback control ay applicable dun sa mga nagbibigay ng servisyo, katulad kunwari ng barbershop o kaya yung sa government, yung kapag yung mga services na in-offer nila, katulad ng sa treasurer's office kapag magbabayad ng mga buwis, ganun. So, pwedeng panghingi ng feedback yung department para mas mapaganda pa yung servisyo na pinaprovide nila. Ito po yung diagram. So, feed forward controls is focus on work inputs. It's ensure the right directions are set and the right resource inputs are available. It solves problem before they occur. So, preventive control. Concurrent control or work throughputs ensure the right things are being done as part of work group operation. It solves problem while they are occurring. And feedback control or work inputs, output po pala ito. Work output, feedback control ensures that final results are up to desired standards. It solves problem after they occur. And the next is internal and external control. Internal control allows motivated individuals and groups to exercise self-discipline in fulfilling job expectation. While external control occurs through personal supervision and use of formal administrative system. Internal control is occurs through self-discipline and self-control. It relies on motivated individuals exercising self-control over their own behavior. Tapos yung external control occurs through direct supervision or administrative system such as rules and procedures. Managers take direct action to control the behavior of others. Na last po. Internal and external control. Self-control is an internal control that occurs through self-discipline in fulfilling work and personal goals and responsibilities. Self-control is also called self-management. It is a control system in which managers and workers control their own behavior. In self-control, leaders and managers provide workers with clear boundaries within which they may guide and control their own goals and behavior. As self-control po, di. Ikaw yung magkocontrol kung paano at kailan mo ma-achieve yung goal mo sa organization. Dito po mapasok yung ano, yung drive mo, yung pagmamanage mo sa sarili mo kung gagawin mo na ba. Kasi merong iba na ano, na lenient na yung hindi siya masyadong focus dun sa ginagawa niya. Dito, pwede kang mag-set ng goal para sa sarili mo, para kunwari, mag-set ka na itong trabaho to magagawa ko to bukas. Tapos, pwede, para mas ma-encourage ka na matapos talaga yun, mag-set ka ng reward para sa sarili mo. Kunwari, ano, pag natapos ko yan, bibili ako ng ganito. Ganyan. Para ma-motivate ka na ma-reach yung goal mo as well as sa pamamagitan nun, ma-reach din ng organization yung goal nila. Next is bureaucratic control. Bureaucratic control influences behavior through authority, policies, procedures, job description, budgets, and day-to-day supervision. It uses rules, policies, hierarchy of authority, written documentation, reward system, and other formal mechanism to influence employee behavior and assess performance. Bureaucratic control can be used when behavior can be controlled with market or price mechanism. Sa palagay ko, ito yung ginagamit na control dun sa organization ko. Kasi sa accounting, may nakaset na accounting standards na dapat sundin. So, yun. Meron siyang rules and procedures na naka-fix na yun yung dapat mo i-follow para makapag-produce ng output na inline doon sa standards na binigay ng kunwari, ng Commission on Audit. Next is plan control. Plan control influences behavior through norms and expectations set by the organizational culture. It represent cultural values. Ito naman yung kabaliktaran ng bureaucratic control. Kasi is refers to the beliefs and values of the organization that operates more like a family than a company. A clan control, high-level management sees a mentor rather than bosses. Sa control na ito, konti lang yung rules and policies na ini-implement sa organization dahil mas nagre-rely yung organization sa trust ng mga empleyado. Dito din nakafocus yung organization sa teamwork. For example, ginagamit ang clan culture sa kunwari sa mga fashion boutique. Kasi ginagamit nila yung designer, ginagamit niya yung influence ng culture niya para makapag-produce ng damit or gown. Ang disadvantage lang ng clan control ay pwede siyang ma-take advantage ng mga empleyado. Pwedeng hindi nila gawin yung pinaka-best nila kasi yun, may tiwala naman sa kanila yung kumpanya, parang ganun. And the last is the market control. Market control influences of market competition on the behavior of organization and their members. Market control involves use of price competition to evaluate output. Managers compare profits and prices to determine the efficiency of their organization. In order to use market control, there must be a reasonable level of competition in the goods or services area, and it must be possible to specify requirements clearly. Dito sa control na to, market control, katulad ng sa mga television. Sa television, di ba, meron yung ranking kung ano yung mas pinapanood ng tao. Yun yung isa sa example ng market control kasi doon, pareho lang naman ng, kunwari, yung ABS-CBN at GMA nung may franchise pa sila. Though, di ba, sinasabi na number one, telecommunication company, ganun. Kasi doon, mame-measure na, pareho yung service nila, mame-measure, kasi pareho lang yung requirements nila, pareho lang yung pre-provide nila na service. So, clear yung requirements na, na pwede silang pag-comparahin. To sum up po, controlling is a goal-oriented function as it ensures that the resources of an organization are being effectively and efficiently used for the achievement of predetermined goals. It says that the right things happen in the right ways and in the right time. Thank you po. Hello po. Ano yun? Ano yung POLC? Daw po.
Hello ma, narinig ka namin. Ewan ko lang kay sir, si sir Dura.
Wait lang po.